Do I think there will be a sixth generation of Pokemon? Probably. Maybe they'll go all the way to 1,000 Pokemon, and then they may stop at last. But only time will tell, people.
Time certainly did tell, didn't it? And in a much quicker pace than we initially expected.
Generation 6? Is this for real? Are we seriously talking about the sixth generation in Pokemon already? After it has been revealed? I'm not gonna lie to you guys, right? Nintendo, right? You guys have shocked me, right? It takes a lot to surprise me, I will admit to that. Right, there is a lot of times where things that should have surprised me haven't. And people have often said to me, "Does it, how much does it take to surprise you?" And it's very rare I actually do get surprised by something, especially in video games. And I'm gonna have to say that Nintendo and Game Freak, you guys have surprised me, very much surprised me, when I heard about this big announcement that was gonna be taking place on January 8th. I thought to myself, ah, good, are we finally getting a fifth generation version of PBR? Or are we getting more Pokemon games for the fifth generation? Or are they doing something that we simply don't expect? Well, they sure did something that we did not expect. Do you want to know the best part? The best part to all of this? The day before the big reveal actually came about, I was actually talking to my friends on Skype about this, and I actually, we were speculating as exactly what it was, and one of the people in the call actually said, it could be the sixth generation of Pokemon, to which we all responded with, no, it definitely won't be that, because, because it's too soon, it's literally too soon. And we were speculating on that even before it was revealed, and we were coming to conclusions before it was even revealed. So it's making me very surprised at the fact that we were wrong. I'll admit to myself, I was sure it wasn't going to be the sixth generation of Pokemon. But hey, Nintendo, amazing. You've actually done something that has surprised me, very much surprised me. The reveal of Black and White 2 surprised me a little bit, but it didn't surprise me a lot, And also the fact that we're going back to the colors with the fifth generation surprised me a little bit, but not a lot. But this is shocked me. I mean, let's take a bit of a let's go through the past 2 years that has happened here on the Pokemon community. Right, now, keep in mind that I'm going by the English dates. I know the Japanese have had it for over 2 years. It has been quite a long time since the Japanese got it. So I'm going to go by the English dates, which is US and UK. Right, the US and UK got the first fifth generation games in early 2011. Pokémon White and Black came out, I think it was around March 11th over here, if my memory is serving me right. I think it was around March 11th, somewhere around that time frame, right? It's been less than 2 years since the reveal of fifth generation on the Pokemon games, and already we're getting announced that sixth generation is starting to enter the woodwork. This has really surprised me. I cannot express. I know you may think I'm exaggerating a bit on this, but I really am not. I am very, very surprised by what has happened here. I mean, I think one of the reasons, though, why people are as surprised as they have is because of the fact that we were on fourth generation for quite a long time. Now, again, I'm going to go more back in time here. Right. Fourth generation over here in the US and UK came out early 2007, which was Diamond and Pearl, followed by PBR. Right? And then we didn't get Pokemon Black and White till 2011, early 2011. So that has been pretty much 4 years, and I think that is why we are so surprised, because we got used to the generations being quite a gap in between each announcement. I think that's why a lot of us are really surprised at the fact that Sixth Generation has already been announced, and worldwide. Actually, this is a good idea. I'm happy about this. Now, no offense to Japanese people, I can safely say that I've got nothing against Japanese. In fact, in the video game community, I actually have a lot of self-respect. A lot of respect for the Japanese. I actually consider them to be really good when it comes to video games, because a lot of the classic video game franchises have actually come from Japan. You know, like Street Fighter, Pokemon, you know, I used to think Yu-Gi-Oh, etc, etc. But one thing we can say is I did not like the fact that we had to wait like 6 months after the Japanese got theirs, because sometimes when I was playing on black and white random Wi-Fi, I would come across a Japanese player that would have like over 1,000 wins or something, you know, sheer amount of experience over me because they've had the game for a lot longer. And 1,000 wins may seem a bit exaggerated, but I'm talking about those dedicated Pokemon fans that play the game during all their free time since buying it because they are that addicted to the system. Now, this is a good idea. I actually do like the fact that they are releasing it worldwide rather than just keeping it in Japan, then releasing it worldwide after. I'm happy that we are all getting it at the same time. Now, if it was in reverse and we got it before the Japanese and they had to wait 6 months, I wouldn't support that because that would be unfair on the Japanese. Because, you know, to make me not look like a hypocrite, you know, yes, I would be happy that we got it first, but I wouldn't support it on the Japanese end. I would be, you know, I'd have sympathy towards the Japanese for making them wait instead of us. So I am happy that it's a fair basis. It's all going to be released at exactly the same time. Now, one thing I want to do before I come to my conclusion for this is I actually want to take a look at the Pokemon that were revealed so far in the trailers that have been released so far. So let's take a look at them.
Okay then, so the first one that I want to look at is probably my least favourite out of all of them, but I still think it's okay, which is this one, who is named Chespin. Now, Chespin intrigues me a bit, mainly because of the fact that when you look at some of the grass types that have come before in previous generations, a lot of them are pretty much focused on the colour green, which does make sense because they are resembling the grass area. This one, as you can plainly see, is not 100% green. In fact, it's more brown and dark brown than it is actual green. Now, I don't know about the back, but I'm guessing the whole back is probably green. So, this does interest me because of the fact that it's not just based around green, it's more a multitude of colouring. So, it's decent. It's not overly, I can't say I love it. I like it. That's probably the best thing I can say about it. You know, I mean, it's not as cool as Snivy. You know, it's not as cool as Snivy, I'll admit to that. But I am interested to see what its evolutions are going to look like, which is probably something that can be said about all three of them. So, a good start, I think, but this is probably my least favourite one out of all of them. The next one is this one. Now, which is Froakie? I think you pronounce it. I hope I'm saying this right, but let's just go with Froakie for now. Now, this, I'm actually surprised, has not been done sooner, because it's obviously meant to resemble a frog, which does make sense. And considering the fact that, well, apart from Politoed, of course, we haven't really got any water Pokemon that are focused around the, well, the frog area, so you could say, especially in the starters. So, for that reason alone, I like this thing. I think this looks pretty decent. Again, I like it a little bit more than the last one, but I can't say I'm, you know, enthusiastic about it. I can't say I love it, if you know what I mean. But I imagine its final form is going to look something like maybe a giant-sized toad, maybe, or maybe, or maybe even a sea creature, because we all know Pokemon and Logic are like, well, that you just can't work with them. Yeah, you know, they just don't work together. They're like water and oil. But in all honesty, I like this thing. I think it's got potential, and I'm hoping they're not going to mess up its design. It's one of the things that bothered me a bit about Tepig, because Tepig had a cool design at the start, and in Emboa, while I do like it, I do feel as though it could have been better. So I'm hoping they're not going to go the same route with this little guy. So I see a lot of potential here, and I have a feeling it's going to look pretty sweet in the long run. So, pretty much the same as the last one, just I like it a little bit more. Now, for more commonly, the last one is seems to be the favorite, and it's definitely my favorite by quite far, actually. I think this thing looks pretty awesome, and I'm really hoping that it maintains its awesomeness throughout its evolutions, assuming it's going to get evolutions, of course. Because these are presumably the starters, but at this point, I really don't know what to say because, Nintendo seem to be on this goal to be as unpredictable as possible. So, for all we know, these could just be free starters, free Pokemon that they just randomly picked of the three main types and tried to portray them as the starters. So, I'm gonna say they are the starters, but I'm not going to declare it if you know what I mean. But looking at Finnegan's appearance, I think it looks pretty sweet, to be perfectly honest. The tail reminds me a bit of Eevee for some reason, and I like how its hair comes out of its ears a little bit different, granted, unless I'm missing something here. But when I look at the body structure as well, between its tail and head, that reminds me a little bit of Virizion for some reason. Don't ask me why that is. I think it's just the way it's walking. It reminds me a little bit of Virizion. Maybe I'm being a little bit over observative, but it's hard to say. But this is definitely my favorite of the three, and I've had pretty much a lot of people agree with me on that. So, yeah, I only hope it maintains its awesomeness through its evolutions. So, starting off with the legendaries now, and starting with Pokemon Y. Now, this Pokemon is actually like a big bird designed to represent a Y. Now, I actually like this idea because they're actually making the Pokemon's appearance and structure match the game that it's representing. Now, in the past, you've always had, the Pokemon that have represented the game haven't really marked off the game they're representing. The only real exception you can have is Dialga, Palkia, and Giratina, because Giratina has like a platinum diamond or thing, well, like a platinum round its chest, so to say, you know what I'm on about. Whereas Dialga and Palkia also have the orbs that represent a diamond and a pearl. Kyogre and Groundon were more about the weather rather than the appearance, but this actually takes on the actual design of the game, and in all honesty, I think this thing looks pretty awesome, to be honest. It doesn't look like anything that has been designed beforehand, although this might be a little bit thrown out there, but when I looked at the face, for some reason it reminded me a bit of Mandibuzz. I know that may seem a little bit weird, but I'm only focusing on the face, but if you look at the face, it just makes me think of Mandibuzz. Don't ask me why, it just does. So, taking a look at the second one now, which is representing Pokemon X. Well, for starters, it may look like a Y on appearance, but if it spreads its legs out, it actually does look like an X. And it also provokes sex jokes. Yes, I know. Leave them in the comments if you want. But anyway, on appearance, this thing looks pretty awesome. I think it's my favourite out of the entire set. I know I said Finnegan was my favourite, but that was out of the starters. I think out of the entire set, I think this one's my favourite. So, definitely interested to see what types these are actually going to be, because I can't quite decide what types these are going to actually be. I mean, obviously, the Pokemon Y is probably going to be a flying, but this looks like it could be a steel type, maybe, or maybe a psychic type, it's hard to say. Maybe even a water type, because it has got some blue elements to it. But, who knows? Maybe they're bringing new types. I wouldn't encourage it, but at the same time, it would be interesting. But, in all honesty, I like this Pokemon. I think it looks really good on appearance. It does certainly represent the game that it's going to be featured in. So, I have high hopes for this one as well. So, that's pretty much all I have to say about these individual Pokemon. I can't give too much praise because there's not much to know about these guys to begin with, other than what I've already said. But I am definitely looking forward to seeing how these guys are going to stand out. I have high hopes for the evolutions of the three quote-unquote starters. So that's all I can say about the Pokemon individually.
So all in all, Pokemon X and Pokemon Y, am I happy by this or am I disappointed? I am happy. Not only just because it shows that they are up in their game, they are actually giving us new content at a reasonable time frame now, you know, and to be perfectly honest, I'm actually quite excited for this, and at least now, Pokemon fans actually have a reason to buy a 3DS, unless they've already got one, of course. So I am happy by this reveal. I'm a little bit disappointed that it's not a 5th generation PBR, but this is more than enough to compensate for it. You know, the attack animations I saw in the trailer actually look really, really fun. And considering how many Pokemon there is and how many stuff's going to take place here, yeah, we don't even know. We might actually get new evolutions here. You know, maybe new evolutions of previous generations. You know, who knows? Maybe we'll get those things we wanted after all. So, it's almost like they put in 5th generation to fill in for the time frame they needed to do 6th generation, but, you know, I could be wrong about that, but nevertheless, I am happy by this. It's a good idea. I think it's going at a good pace now, and I think it's going to make the franchise even better. Let's just hope they don't mess it up. Let's just say that, because there's only been about 5 Pokemon revealed so far. Let's just pray that they stay good, you know, because I like the ones they've got so far, obviously. So, that's all I can say about the matter. Leave a video response, leave a comment below on what your take on all this is. See you guys later.